The one yearbook note Moore Accuser wishes she didn't write. Ex-boyfriend doubts Roy Moore Accuser's story. Republican Alabama U.S. Senate candidate Judge Roy Moore has been attacked viciously in recent weeks amid claims that he sexually assaulted teenage girls nearly four decades ago. Last week, Accuser Beverly Young Nelson and her attorney, Gloria Allred, held a news conference during which Nelson claimed Moore sexually assaulted her when she was 16 years old. During the news conference, they brought forward a yearbook that reportedly had Moore's signature in it, with an inscription complimenting Nelson's appearance. Moore has challenged the validity of the yearbook note, calling it a forgery and requesting that it go before a handwriting expert for analysis. In a Skype interview with Breitbart, a man who said he dated Nelson around the same time that she claims to have been sexually assaulted by Moore contends that he doesn't believe the allegations made by Nelson. Trending, developing, another Dem. Bites the dust, John Conyers caught in explosive sex accusations. Jeff Devine, who is now a minister in Thailand, said he went to high school with Nelson and remembers dating her around 1977. Devine also brought forward a high school yearbook, which he said contains an inscribed message from Nelson. Per the yearbook, the inscription was signed Beverly Young, which is Nelson's maiden name. A screenshot of the yearbook from Breitbart also shows Beverly Young wrote a lengthy message, where she even explained where her house was located. The yearbook inscription bolsters Devine's claims that he and Nelson knew each other, and knew each other very well, around the time she claims Moore assaulted her. I certainly wouldn't qualify as an expert, but I have been in ministry for many years, Devine told Breitbart. I have dealt with a lot of people. People that have been through trauma. People that have been molested or hurt and all kinds of situations. I have learned to just study body language and the way a person tells a story. And as I said, I wouldn't qualify, I am sure, in a court of law as being an expert. But just from my experience, I didn't find her story believable. And the way she told it, he added. Devine took issue with Nelson's story and the accusations she has levied against Moore. I could only guess to her motive, Devine said. Whether somebody has offered her something to do this. I really couldn't say. I would only be guessing. Devine is the second person who claims to know Nelson and has publicly questioned her allegations against Moore. Nelson's stepson, Daryl Nelson, said last week that his stepmom's accusations against Moore were 100% a lie. The yearbook, which plays a big role in Nelson's claim, has been challenged by Moore. Last Wednesday, Moore's attorney demanded that Allred and Nelson allow a handwriting expert to analyze the yearbook to verify that it has not been tampered with or forged. Allred said she would only hand over the yearbook if Moore testified before a congressional hearing, but she also won't unequivocally say the yearbook is credible, either. During a phone interview with CNN's Wolf Blitzer last week, Allred refused to say whether Moore's signature in Nelson's yearbook was authentic. Blitzer asked, "Can you say flatly to our viewers right now, Gloria, that the signature, what he wrote in that yearbook in 1977, according to her, can you say flatly that was not a forgery?" Well, all I'm saying is we will permit an independent examiner of the writing to look at exemplars of the former judge. We will allow all of this to be asked and answered at the hearing, Allred replied. Moore has vehemently denied the allegations made against him in recent weeks. Allred's refusal to release the yearbook for analysis, coupled with Devine saying Nelson's accusations against Moore are unbelievable, raises serious questions about whether Moore actually did the things he has been accused of doing. Nelson's ex-boyfriend claiming that she is lying is a major revelation, but don't expect to see it in the mainstream media.